Byron's mom left Jamaica as a teenager and came to Ohio, where she worked for 2 years to pay off her travel expenses. Frida's mother left the Dominican Republic with her children so that her son could get the medical attention he needed. Frida was 8 when she came to New York City. She quickly learned English and became the neighborhood interpreter, helping people deal with the issues that confront so many immigrants. Byron spent his first years in the Bronx. Then his mother moved the family to Syracuse, where his father was critically ill. When his father died, the family was left with a home, but little else. But his mother encouraged her children to pay attention to the world around them. By his high school years, Byron was leading demonstrations against Woolworths to protest the chain's discriminatory practices. For TE youth, their lives serve as models for challenging stereotypes. Frida and Byron were among the first in their families to go to college. Frida got her BA from the New School of Social Research. Byron left Harvard after his junior year to work for the Congress of Racial Equality in Syracuse. In 1964, he returned to Boston and was hired by Sarah Ann Shaw of the Northern Student Movement to work on voter registration. About the same time, Frida arrived in Boston and became involved with community issues and anti-war activities. Byron was one of the first to work with black youth to oppose the Vietnam War and was a conscientious objector. The history of that war has many lessons. Lessons that the young people of teen empowerment have learned and communicated to their peers. In 1965, Frida got a job at the welfare department in Grove Hall and was disturbed by how disrespectfully the department treated its clients. Normal procedure involved insulting comments and unannounced home visits. When a demonstration by so-called welfare mothers led to riots, Frida was not surprised, and Byron was arrested for supporting the mothers. This system was not the place for Frida. Soon, Hubie Jones hired her to work at the Roxbury Multi-Service Center. He encouraged her to develop her skills as a social worker and an organizer. One of her first community projects was stopping the expansion of a Roxbury gas station. Meanwhile, some suburbanites and contractors were using Roxbury parks as dumping grounds. Byron and his neighborhood cohorts assembled the refuse in one park into a mountain and, with the media watching, set it alight. The front page Globe photo of Minister Gil Caldwell being hosed by firefighters catalyzed the city to clean up the park. This project sparked the creation of the country's first neighborhood-controlled community development corporation, which went on to design and build affordable housing in Madison Park Village. In the 70s, Frida helped found La Alianza Hispana, which has provided services to thousands of Latinos. She started a rape prevention program for the Solomon Carter Fuller Center, and she helped fight the battle to desegregate the Boston public schools. Byron worked with Mel King to develop the Center for Inner City Change, where he and Frida met. For 20 years, Frida was executive director of United South End Settlements, starting an adult literacy program, expanding housing, elderly and preschool services, and raising the money to renovate the agency's facilities. She also chaired the committee that placed the Harriet Tubman and Emancipation statues on Columbus Avenue. Conversations with filmmaker Henry Hampton inspired Byron to raise funds to renovate the African Meeting House and to organize the Museum of Afro-American History and the Black Heritage Trail. Frida and Byron believe that people who lose their history cannot hope to control their futures. Teen Empowerment shares this belief. When Mel King ran for mayor, Byron was elected to his state house seat. Since 1983, Byron has fought for the rights and needs of his constituents, speaking out against injustice and leading the effort to make our state the first to divest from South Africa and Burma. And over the years, Frida has been a member of 75 organizations, working on housing, bilingual education, war resistance, welfare rights, education, and economic opportunity. Teen Empowerment has the deepest respect for the lives of Frida and Byron. They inspire the next generation to overcome their challenges and to work for justice in our world.